Good evening, everyone. This is Mike O'Malley here with the Hurricane Outlook and discussion for May 26, 2020. Just a quick video update here regarding Invest 90L and our Eastern Pacific system. Invest 91L now has a 30% chance of development over the next 24 hours, really, as it's only going to have about 24 hours to actually develop here. Again, this is a system that has moved off of the coast of Florida, bringing all the torrential rainfall to portions of Southeast Florida, Miami, those regions, the Florida East Coast throughout the day yesterday and this morning. That has now moved off during the day today and has developed a pretty robust area of showers and thunderstorms around a common center. This has a chance and a shot of becoming a tropical cyclone within the next 12 to 18 hours before it eventually makes landfall somewhere out here, either near in South Carolina or in North Carolina. And our Eastern Pacific system has a 70% chance over the next 5 days as a system nearing as what's called a Central American gyre. It's going to set up across this region and likely promote tropical cyclone Genesis near or just south of Central America. And this is likely to have some impacts to Central America over the next coming days. So this is going to be something to watch here if you live along the Central American coastline here, really all the way from the Yucatan Peninsula, Belize City, all the way in through Central America. These are going to be the places that you want to watch here over the next coming days, as it's relatively uncertain what's going to happen. The GFS, both the GFS and the European model, try to pull some of this energy into the southern Bay of Campeche here over the next coming days, and we'll have to really take a look at that here in tomorrow's outlook and certainly over the next coming days. Again, there's that area, 30% chance over the next 5 days, and then our Eastern Pacific system has a 70% chance over the next 5 days as it nears the Central American coastline here. And if you take a look here at the satellite imagery, this is coming from COD Meteorology, the College DuPage website. You guys do notice that we do have what is now 90L or 91L that has now passed over the Gulf Stream. And this is allowing for convection to develop across this region. Pretty robust convection. All of these, what's known as hot towers developing. And these will try to rotate around a common center, a common axis center. And what this is going to do is lower the pressures down there. And that should promote some tropical cyclone genesis, or at least give it a chance to develop into somewhat of a tropical cyclone over the next coming hours here, the next really 12 to 18 hours before it actually does make landfall somewhere near South Carolina or the North Carolina-South Carolina border. So it is very important to understand that while this may not be a very strong system, this will bring the threat for very heavy rainfall to portions of the Carolinas here, especially if you live along the coast, down east North Carolina, you know, the low country of South Carolina. Those are going to be the areas that are going to be most impacted, and eventually the system is going to bring rain really up into the Raleigh area, Greenville, Spartanburg, all the way throughout those areas. So it's very important to understand that there will be the chance for some very heavy rainfall over the next few days that's going to set up across that region. Now, taking a look here at the sea surface temperatures, this is the actual sea surface temperatures coming off the CDAS methodology from tropicaltidbits.com. You guys do notice that this area is going to be running in the Gulf Stream out here with about water temperatures ranging from about 25 to about 28 degrees Celsius. And that is certainly that 26 to especially in the 28 degrees Celsius isotherms, those are going to be the temperatures that are going to support the tropical, you know, tropical cyclone genesis. Again, we touched on this earlier, but generally most of the Gulf of Mexico and the Caribbean and the far western part of the Atlantic Main Development Region is now conductive, at least in the sea surface temperature standpoint, for tropical cyclone formation. So we are getting closer and closer to June 1st. We are 6 days away, now approaching 5 days away. So it is very important to understand that, you know, we've already had Tropical Storm Arthur. We might see another system here develop briefly. And the pattern is going to be setting up that as such, we are likely to see a more and more favorable environment setting up over the next coming couple of weeks for some early season activity. Now, if you take a look here, this is from coming from the Central University of Wisconsin-Madison site. This is taking a look at the spin about 5,000 feet off the ground, the 850 millibar vorticity. The higher you go up in this contour, the higher spin, cyclonic spin you're getting in the atmosphere. Again, notice our area of vorticity that's still stretched out. It's still relatively stretched out across portions of the northern Florida Peninsula, even all the way in through portions of the Gulf of Mexico. And this was kind of the lobe of energy that the European was suggesting the other day. One lobe of energy here in the Gulf of Mexico region, and one lobe kind of all the way expanded out through the Florida Peninsula, and then in through the Gulf of Mexico, or not into the Gulf of Mexico, but the southwestern Atlantic, rather. And again, that could be setting up for some isolated development. Now, one hindrance of this is that there is still too much vertical wind shear. If you do look here at the wind shear map, this was updated about 21Z this evening, and you do notice that there is still a decent amount of shear, 30, 25 to 30 knots of shear that's running over top of it, with an additional 40 knots of shear. Now, there is expected to be some lower shear over the next about 12 to 18 hours. And again, that's all the system has, is only about 12 to 18 hours of actual development. So it's not really going to have a lot of time to actually develop and mature itself. However, if we take a look at the latest HWRF model, the 18Z run that was initialized with the model guidance, you notice within the next 18 hours, the HWRF actually tries to develop this into a rather tightly compacted low that's approaching probably right near Charleston, South Carolina. Again, the exact landfall point of whatever this actually turns out to become is very uncertain. Again, there could be some center reformations that could occur, and that might be one of the problems here, is that we've likely already seen a center reformation further off in this band of deeper convection. If we switch real quick to the visible satellite, and we'll switch to the visible satellite right before the sun went down here. We'll just move it out just before the sun went down across the area. You do notice this large area of convection that's out there, and we just kind of let this play. You can definitely see that there's more of that cyclonic turning in the atmosphere. Obviously, some of that deeper convection over Florida here. We'll talk about that here in just a minute, but we could see a center reformation further back off towards the east with this system that may allow just a little bit more time over water. So it's going to be interesting to see exactly what's going to be happening and what actually plays out. But one problem, if we go to the relative humidity here, there is still some drier air that might be entrained on the backside of the system if the HWRF model was to be taken literally. Again, this is just a model. It's not to be taken for gospel per se, but again, there could be a small window of opportunity for Tropical Cyclone Genesis, as 91L is now out in the Gulf Stream in the warmer waters with shear relaxing over the next 12 to 18 hours. This may make a very brief run at becoming a tropical cyclone, but its chances and certainly the timing that it has is going to be very, very limited. Also, one thing to note that we did receive some pretty good rainfall. This is coming from the weather station that we do have out back, and you do notice that we've almost eclipsed almost about an inch of rain today. So certainly one of the more fascinating things. This is all a result of the kind of the backwards push now of 91L. But again, you do notice all that heavy rainfall that did set up through parts of earlier this evening. So again, we're watching a lot of things here. 91L is still drifting out in the open waters here of the southwestern Atlantic and the Gulf Stream. Could become a chance, it could become a very heavy rainfall threat to portions of North Carolina and South Carolina over the next coming days, and also could have a run at developing into a short-lived tropical cyclone near the South Carolina-North Carolina border. And we are also watching the system that is expected to come together in the eastern Pacific, from a Central American gyre, which could have some direct impacts to portions of Central America over the next few days. Of course, stay tuned to the latest information from your local weather service offices and local weather offices across the country. I will be back with another video forecast update tomorrow morning. Stay safe, everyone, and I will see you tomorrow morning.